Hello friends, welcome back. Recently I reviewed the Mi 11 and compared it to the Galaxy S21 from Samsung. And from the basic comparison, it felt that the Mi 11 is slightly better phone than the S21. But there is nothing that replaces a real hands-on review. So here I have the Samsung S21 in a phantom violet color. So let me share my few thoughts regarding this phone. And finally, I'll tell you whether this phone is actually inferior to the Mi 11. Coming from the bigger phones, the S21 feels as a very compact phone. If you have small hands or you really like small phones, then this phone is made for you. The phone is extremely lightweight at just 169 grams, but at the same time, the plastic back and the lightweight do not make the phone feel premium in hand. The weight and feel in hand feels similar to the first generation Samsung Galaxy S, which had a plastic back. But apart from that, this small body is perfectly well balanced and the phantom violet color along with the gold combination looks strikingly good. Among all the colors available, this is the color I really adore. So apart from the build quality of this phone has all the hardware specification of a flagship device, be it the fastest chip available in the market right now, the Gorilla Glass Victus, IP68 rating, a Wi-Fi 6 module, dynamic AMOLED screen, a superb camera setup, a fast UFS 3.1 storage. But talking about the storage this year, Samsung has skipped the microSD card slot, though in my personal opinion, this hardly matters to me as I have stopped using microSD cards on my phone since a year or two. Even though this phone has a compact body, but still it features a good 4000mAh battery, which usually gives a screen on time of around 5 to 6 hours and is just enough to carry you through a 9 to 6 pm day. It supports fast 25 watt charging, a 15 watt of wireless charging and provides reverse wireless charging of around 4.5 watts. Now coming to the striking camera arrangement of this phone. The camera setup of this phone is exactly similar to the S20 Plus series from last year. But overall, on using this camera setup, I feel the camera algorithm is slightly faster and slightly improved. The phone has a 12 megapixel f1.8 main camera, followed by a 64 megapixel f2.0 telephoto camera, and then there is this 12 megapixel f2.2 wide angle camera. The selfie camera is a 10 megapixel f2.2, and with overall usage, I feel this camera is a very potent one, ranging from the photographic capability as well as the videographic capabilities. In the performance section, the phone I have here has the Snapdragon 888 chipset since it has been imported from USA. But there is definite heating issue present with this chipset, especially when you are using the camera. Even with just with the viewfinder on, the area around the camera model heats up quite a bit. I personally feel the Snapdragon 865 was the pinnacle of Qualcomm's chipset performance. So now let us come to the hardware feature that is basically Samsung's forte. Yes, I'm talking about the display quality. This phone has 6.2 inch dynamic AMOLED 2X screen with a 120Hz refresh rate, HDR 10 plus compatibility, a super bright peak brightness of around 1300 nits, but the resolution is now just a full HD plus with a PPI of 421. Now here I am comparing this screen with a mid-range Samsung phone, that is the Galaxy M51 that I have with me now. As you can see from the HDR videos, the Galaxy S21 screen has a superb peak brightness, so HDR videos do look quite bright. But apart from this particular scenario, the Galaxy M51 also has a very good screen with excellent color rendering as well as display quality compared to the S21. And with such a small screen size, there will be hardly any customer base who will do any kind of serious video editing or photo editing on this device, or for that matter any kind of hardcore games. So the only place where the extremely powerful chipset will be used is to drive the powerful camera setup. But even then, this camera setup was already present in the S20 Plus series, which is available for a lot of discount on Flipkart. Even though many other countries got a price reduction compared to the S20 series, in India, the scenario is different. This S21 at a price of around 69,999 rupees should be completely ditched in favor of either the Mi 11 or the last year's excellent S20 phone. The maximum price of this phone without a charger and earphones should have been 50 to 55,000 rupees, in which case this phone would have got my recommendation. But at the present market price, just do not buy this phone if it is your hard-earned money. So this was my opinion regarding the S21, and if you concur with my thoughts, do hit the like button, and if not, let me know in the comment section. So I'll be signing off now, and we'll see you in my next video. Thank you.